Stop chewing up all my toys, boy. It's all you do.
What's going on, everybody? Your boy Juan Valdez here. And sorry for the intro. I had to make sure that Pluto wasn't over there ripping apart all my shoes, because every time I don't see him around and he's either too quiet or just not around where I can see him, he's up to no good. The topic for today is how to build a Shopify store that generates over $40,000 a month. Here's the numbers for this month right here. Almost 50 grand. I'll probably end up hitting 50 grand before the end of the month. I wanted to share with you guys some of the key components that kind of go in to having a store that consistently generates $50,000 to $100,000 a month. Honestly, it's been all on autopilot the last 3 or 4 weeks or so. So me and my business partner Samir have been split testing on ClickFunnels as well, driving traffic on there, seeing how products also do on there. But this store has still been up and running with all the systems that we have in place, and it's consistently been generating that type of revenue every single month. And so I wanted to kind of share with you guys some of the key components I think go into that. So right, I'm actually outside of my place here. I usually, when I talk to people about e-commerce, I like to give them my perspective on e-commerce, right? Because for me, and some of you guys that are watching now, you know that drop shipping or e-commerce, I like to personally think about e-commerce overall, not just specifically drop shipping. We're in the e-commerce space, right? A lot of you guys that are watching want to learn more about e-commerce overall, how to make money online. And so when I think about e-commerce, I don't think it's as easy anymore as just finding a quick product and putting it on Facebook and like making money overnight. It's no longer like that, right? Obviously, you have to be able to adapt to the market. The market's a lot more sophisticated, so you have to be able to do the right things in order to actually get results if you guys want to actually, you know, see and make any money with drop shipping, right? If you guys actually want to get results with e-commerce, you want, again, you have to respect the market. And so the way I like to think about e-commerce and drop shipping is that, again, it's a lot more than just finding a product and putting it on Facebook and putting it on your store and just making money overnight. You have to think about e-commerce as an actual business that has different parts to the business, right? So whenever I talk about e-commerce, I always like to break down e-commerce into 5 different areas of e-commerce, right? So what I mean by that is you have your store creation and store optimization. That's like one area of e-commerce that like has its own process and has things that go into play specifically just for that. So you can't just try to put together a store that isn't really optimized, because again, it's not going to work. So that's a really important area when it comes to e-commerce. And again, it's not just about a simple Shopify store, right? If you want to do e-commerce overall, sell your own products, you're going to have to learn how to set up a website, you know, and optimize it correctly to actually sell the products that you have. So that's, you know, it's super important. You then have product and market research. That's another area of e-commerce that's super important as well, right? It has its own components to it. It has product research, different resources to cross-reference the products that you actually found to make sure those products actually worth testing, and a whole lot more, right? So obviously product research is a whole other area that it's honestly super important to the business as well. I think that all areas are important, but you know, obviously some of the first few are a lot more important than some of the others. For example, like, you know, store creation is a lot more important than like automation, because you can't even get to automation if you can't create the right kind of store. Just to kind of give you guys some insight. After that, you then have your marketing, right? The different ways you can drive traffic and get people to actually come to your website and your store. And that's an area that's super important, right? Learning the ins and outs. You have Facebook ads, Instagram ads, Snapchat ads, Pinterest, Twitter, all these different platforms you can use to market, and, you know, influencer marketing, all these different ways. That area of e-commerce, it's super important all on its own. You have to give it its respect and also learn how it actually works and all the ins and outs work if you actually want to get results, you know, driving traffic and actual marketing. After that, you have backend, right? Learning how to upsell and downsell customers that you bring through the door and how to build relationships with them so you can actually sell to them again, right? And remarket to the same customers you already have. There's no point of always trying to bring in brand new customers every single time. Of course, you want to get new customers, but you also want to be able to remarket to the customers you already brought into the door. The easiest customers you guys are always going to have are customers that have already purchased from you. It's always been like that, right? In almost any business, everybody knows this, that customers you already have through the door, you know, they're the first ones that will probably buy from you if you ever have any new products and things like that. You want to make sure you learn how to do that, and you learn all the components of having a back-end system, because if you don't, well, then you're always going to be fighting to get new customers rather than utilizing the customers you already have and you've already brought to the door. And the last area of e-commerce is automation, right? And being able to get help, have a team, and scale up. Obviously, your goal, if you really want to, you know, be able to have a store that generates $40,000, $100,000, whatever the case may be, you're going to need to have a team in place so that you can get help, right? Because you can no longer do those kind of numbers consistently all by yourself. Luckily, you know, I have a team that helps me out, and that's obviously how I'm able to have the freedom to train travel and do all the things I want to do while the store is still running. But if it wasn't for the team, then I wouldn't be able to do so. And so for me, I like to think about e-commerce in that perspective, because then I have a much better understanding of knowing like all the things that have to go into play in order to actually see results. I know for a fact that for all you guys that are watching, if there's any of you that are just thinking you're just gonna come in, put a store together, put some products up, and like just run a Facebook and you're gonna make money, it's not gonna work like that. It's a lot more valuable also for you to learn all the ins and outs of all the different areas of e-commerce, right? Learn all the ins and outs of product research, learn all the ins and outs of marketing, because these are all skill sets that once you learn them, you basically will always have for yourself, right? And these are very valuable skill sets. Think of it like this: if you ever have your own products, you've already sold a ton of other people's products, so it's gonna be a lot easier to sell your own products, right? And do it efficiently. And so obviously the ultimate goal, at least like for me and some of the things I work with my business partner, is, you know, having our own products, because we know for sure that we can have a lot higher of margin. And if we have a more established brand, well, we can make a lot more money with that than selling other people's products. So obviously that's like, again, a whole other part of e-commerce as well. But e-commerce is huge, right? You have so many different areas within e-commerce. Obviously you can make money drop shipping, but you can make money with your own products. You can consult other people that have products they want to sell that aren't doing it the right way. Like, there's so many different avenues when it comes to e-commerce. So learning all the skill sets and everything that goes into play to actually run a successful e-commerce business is super important. So I honestly just wanted to get that message out there for you guys, because I know a lot of you guys watching, like, you know, you get started and you don't get results, it's pretty easy to get turned off by e-commerce and not want to do it anymore. But I'm telling you guys, you always got to think about the bigger picture. Learning these skill sets, it's going to take some time. Like, you're definitely not going to learn everything you need to learn right away. It's going to take some time. Now it's been over 2 years that I've been in the e-commerce space, and I'm still learning up to date, right? Still going to events, still reading books, still buying courses on e-commerce. Like, I'm consistently learning. It's a never-ending process with e-commerce. It's a beautiful Saturday morning here in Los Angeles. I've actually been up since 6 a.m. I've been trying out a new schedule here where I wake up super early, around like 5 or 6, and just get straight to work. I stop around maybe like noontime, go to the gym, come back, chill for a little bit, and then finish off the day with some more work, and then chill the second half of the day. It's been working out pretty well for me. I'm thinking about recording some more videos on things like daily routine and like fitness, working out, and just healthy lifestyle, healthy living. Because lately I've been focusing a lot more on that, I would say, just because I went through a certain time in my life where I really got out of shape and I didn't like how I was. So I started focusing a lot more on that. And as a result, I've started feeling better, working better, and just being a lot more efficient overall. That's pretty much it for this video. If you guys learned anything at all from this video, I'd appreciate if you dropped a like. If you have any questions about anything that we went over, drop it in the comments below. If you haven't already, make sure you join the V fam, smash that subscribe button, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.